多謝各位新聞界朋友今日參加長江實業和長江和記2022年度全年業績記者會，歡迎大家透過網上直播參加問答環節。
Dear members of the press, welcome you all to the CK Asset and CK Hutchison Annual Results Press Conference Webcast.
在開始問答環節之前，我先介紹今日出席記者會的董事。
Prior to our Q&A session, I would like to take this opportunity to introduce to you our directors who are attending today's press conference.
長江實業主席兼董事總經理及長江和記主席兼集團聯席董事總經理李澤鉅先生。
Mr. Victor T.K. Lee, Chairman and Managing Director of CK Asset and Chairman and Group Co-Managing Director of CK Hutchison.
長江實業及長江和記副董事總經理金慶林先生。
Mr. H.L. Kam, Deputy Managing Director of CK Asset and CK Hutchison.
長江實業及長江和記副董事總經理葉德全先生。
Mr. Edmund Ip, Deputy Managing Director of CK Asset and CK Hutchison.
長江和記集團聯席董事總經理霍建寧先生。
Mr. Canning Fok, Group Co-Managing Director of CK Hutchison.
長江和記集團財務董事兼副董事總經理陸法蘭先生。
Mr. Frank Six, Group Finance Director and Deputy Managing Director of CK Hutchison.
我們在今日問答環節的主持，我是長江實業的 Wendy. I'm Wendy Tong Barnes from CK Asset.
我是長江和記的 Laura. I'm Laura Chung from CK Hutchison.
今日的主題是有關兩間公司的業績，業務以外的問題抱歉恕不作答。大家可以將問題輸入直播頁面的信息欄，中文的問題將會以廣東話回答，而英文的問題則以英文回答。另外，由於時間有限，大家提交的問題如果是類同的話，我們會將這些問題歸納集中處理，而不會逐一讀出的，希望大家理解。
As today's press conference is organized for the results announcement of the two companies, non-business related questions will not be addressed. Please send in your questions through the message box on the webcast page. Please note that questions in Chinese will be answered in Cantonese, while English questions will be responded to in English. And given the limited time available, we might be consolidating similar questions for handling instead of addressing them individually.
現在開始今日的業績的問題環節。
QA session begins now.
第一條問題是有關於長實的，記者朋友就說在長實的主席報告那裡，就主席李生就講及集團好像以前一樣，就是展現韌力，其實集團有什麼特質令到長實有這個韌力呢？
應該咁講，我哋唔係做一個單一嘅業務。我哋有選擇，其實有好多選擇。可以針對嘅唔同嘅地方、唔同嘅業務，同埋最緊要唔同嘅經濟周期，靈活咁將嗰個香港人叫走位啦，但係其實可以話靈活咁將唔同嘅資產資本擺喺唔同嘅資產方面，咁變咗可以平衡嗰個發展。加上公司嘅財務穩健咧，現金流充裕，所持有嘅優質資產係抗跌力比較強，所以有條件可以靈活咁應對市場嘅變化同埋波動。或者我舉個實際啲嘅例子咧，就是、早幾年，譬如香港地產業競爭比較激烈嘅時候，地價好貴下，大幅上升，我哋變咗有個選擇可以去外邊發展，投資喺基建啊，或者其他固定嘅收入項目，喺適當嘅時間仲可以鎖定收成。譬如喺英國，我哋買咗 Five Broadgate， 持咗三年半之後再賣出。回報率有成40%多。另外飛機嗰個收租業務，如果你計嗰個 咁多年嘅 cash flow 啊，同埋個 earnings 啊，嗰、那個 internal rate of return 即係中文叫內部回報率，大概都差唔多有雙位數字。所以而家我哋變咗可以講叫 war chest 啊，比較充裕。所以呢幾年香港地價比較合理嘅時候，我哋咪可以買多幾個項目咯。嗱，嗰個下邊即係一個舉例，即係我哋可以喺唔同嘅 cycle， 唔同 industry 有唔同嘅 cycle， 我哋變咗可以有選擇啦。我諗最緊要講係我哋有選擇啦。
OK， 主席，跟住有兩條問題類似嘅，我歸納做一條啊。咁問題就係咧，喺2022年咧，疫情持續啦，又有俄烏戰爭啦，通脹加劇啦，同埋好多國家個經濟咧都下滑緊嘅。咁呢啲情況點樣影響到長和嗰個業務咧？
呢個麥頂住埋幾舒服，我而家咁講聽唔聽到啊？聽唔聽到啊？聽到 ，OK。就2022年係辛苦嘅，即係唔可以話容易嘅年嚟嘅，困難重重嘅。但係由公司譬如 Synovus 咁，貢獻係理想嘅。同埋今年，我叫今年，我講2022年，集團喺度完成咗好多主要嘅策略交易，所以可以2022年錄得淨盈利嘅淨額增長有成 10%。2022年大部分地區慢慢走出嗰個疫情嘅陰影啦，所以好多個國家同好多個行業都受到好影響，但係呢個經濟開始嗰陣時，開始復甦嗰陣時咧，個需求又升得快，勞動市場都緊張，嗰個 supply chain 即係供應鏈咧，亦都好多限制。跟住烏克蘭嘅衝突啦，呢個大家都知道啦，所以變咗好多國家推出好多強烈嘅貨幣應對政策，利率就變咗係我諗上升嘅速度幾十年最高的了，最快的了，變了個匯率方面呢，對我們就有些不利的，就是美元尤其是對英鎊和歐羅升到20多年的高位，有些地方也都有持續的防疫限制，令到我們在內地和香港的業務都增長是辛苦的，還有如果在電訊方面那個成本增加呢，是我們最大的頭痛。所以2022年，大家同事是做了很多功課 才交到這份成績表出來的。 Thank you。
OK， 下一條問題呢就又講長實又講長和了，就他說這個記者朋友呢就說長實和長和呢這一兩年呢都賣了很多的海外的資產，咁請問而家係咪話諗住投資嘅重心翻返嚟香港咧？而家好似喺香港，你哋都買咗啲地，咁又會唔會喺內地嗰度度買嘢啊？
最後都係睇 return 嘅啫。作為好似我頭先第一個問題講嗰、那個，我用嗰個字選擇啦。作為跨國企業，成個無論長江和記或者長實嘅，每日都有很多投資的選擇，不同地區啦，不同行業啦，對於有高回報的優質資產呢，我們無論香港、內地或者其他地方我都會考慮的。對股東來說，集團在哪個地方賣樓不重要，最重要是賺到錢回來，即是我香港賣樓或者在倫敦賣那座 office building， 錢都是回來公司的。長江集團是全球的公司來的，幾十年已經在全球各地投資，對於我們來說那些不是外國來的，對我們也是一個本地市場來的。所以我想我們不是將那個問題不是香港 vs 外國，是不同的 cycle， 我們有這個選擇。我想第一個問題是應該撥落這個問題比較好一點。
OK， 咁下一條問題咧，就係講關於嗰啲海外嘅基建投資啦。咁呢個記者朋友咧就話，長實同埋長建咧都好多合作嘅投資喺海外嘅。咁咧呢啲基建投嘅資產咧，又冇受到全球通脹嘅影響咧？
我想通脹對基建呢要分開幾個角度講，即係對普通營商嘅，你話 telecom 啊咩嘢就係個成本增加咩，但對基建行業嚟講有啲特別嘅。H 如果講得唔啱，你補充我呢樣嘢。特別係講緊水啊、電啊、天然氣呢啲公共嘅事務嚟講，因為我哋喺公共事務裏面有個實質嘅准許回報機制，嗰、那個資產價值咧，嗱、這個留意呢、這個點。平時我哋講通脹係嗰年嘅 costing 啊，或者 revenue 啊，或者 EBITDA 嘅影響。但係對呢啲受規管嚟講，個資產價值係跟嗰個通脹上調嘅，即係個本上嘅，唔係淨係個 revenue 上，係個本上嘅。所以當通脹高嗰陣時咧，我哋嗰個本錢係跟住上嘅，所以佢嘅利增加嘅 profit 咧，唔會喺嗰年顯出嚟，係之後未來幾十年都會出嚟嘅。如果高過經過高通脹之後，所以呢個係基建同其他行業唔同。
主席，或者可以補多一句咧，就係、是、喺我哋好多啲受管制項目咧，係同政府當地嘅政府咧有嗰啲利潤嘅細則嘅。好多時候如果通脹係增加成本，同樣地咧，佢個機制咧亦都容許翻嗰因為通脹咧而增加翻個收入，而因為嗰、那個如果係即係運作做得好咧，其實因為通脹嘅機制咧，仲可以俾到我哋多咗個因為做得好而個利潤空間添嘅。
係啊，
咁純粹睇下做得好唔好啦。
所以對基建嗰行嚟講，通脹可能係好消息嚟嘅。
OK， 跟住呢位記者就提到咧，佢話行政長官上個月就帶團出訪中東，仲簽咗好多項協議啦。咁佢就問啦，咁長和對中東呢個區嘅發展空間咧，有咩睇法咧？
我嗡歪咗個麥冇問題啊嘛，
聽到
，OK。就我哋喺二十年前已經喺中東噶啦，做港口嘅。就而家該呢個地區裏邊五個國家九個港口，擁有19個泊位嘅，所以。咁多年嚟，中東都係我哋一個重要嘅市場嚟嘅。Watson 市亦都睇到呢個商機，所以喺中東嘅三個國家 ，Saudi 啦、Qatar 啦，同埋阿聯酋咧，總共有呢度有成4800萬嘅人口，所以Watson 市喺嗰度都一路喺度擴大嗰個鋪嘅數目，而家。如果啱啱啲同事俾我嘅數就已經去到有17間嘅啦，同埋繼續會揾到新嘅機會，我哋都繼續做嘅。咁行政長官出訪中東，我哋當然支持啦。就我哋和記港口嘅董事總經理亦都參與呢個訪問團嚟嘅。啊，我哋嗰度都幾本地嘅啦。
主席，跟住呢條其實都有 follow up， 跟住有 follow up question 就係咁，如果除咗中東地區之外咧，咁屈臣氏認為仲有邊啲市場咧係有龐大嘅發展潛力咧？同埋會唔會喺內地咧仲開多啲新鋪，同埋加大個投資咧？
Dominic 係咪 online 㗎 ？Dominic 係
online。
Dominic 嚇，如果我答得唔準嘅呢啲係大家同事俾我一齊講嘅數字啊。現在我亞洲當然是我們主要市場，但是如果以當地貨幣計算，我們的 EBITDA 是拿了成 33% 的增長，大部分來自馬來西亞、泰國、菲律賓和土耳其，由於疫情限制解除和新店開張，變成那個店鋪的流量就增加同埋帶嚟銷售幾好嘅，咁就我哋亞洲係發展得幾理想嘅。如果講暫時嘅做得呢期咧，唔好講長期啦，呢期嘅冠軍就應該係馬來西亞，就應該係穩佔市場第一位噶啦，其中一個最發展得最快嘅亞洲市場。咁就喺菲律賓都開咗第1000間鋪啦，當地嘅即係。 近年社區藥房嗰個模式都啲客幾中意，所以我哋嗰個 O plus O 嘅 online offline 嘅保健同美容服務應該係唔止站穩陣腳噶啦，已經開始喺度增長緊。內地就2022年咧就因為封城嘅限制，都一定係辛苦咗噶啦。不過2023年應該開曬噶啦，啲嘢一路會好啲噶啦。內地都超過3900間鋪啦，而家同埋會尋求新嘅發展機會嘅。唔該。
Okay,
今日有冇漏啊？我
冇，講得非常好。
Thank you
。下一條問題咧就係關於樓市噶啦，咁咧就想問主席啊，長實對於未來樓市有啲咩睇法？
哇！呢、這個冇得水晶球嘅喎。剛性需求香港一定有嘅，因為無論你住開咩單位咧，香港比起全世界都可以講住得太細嘅。唔同嘅。無論豪宅、中級嘅基層嘅都係住得太細嘅，所以我諗香港政府一路都係想盡快增加供應，令到個價錢同埋市民嘅購買力係同步嘅嘢嚟嘅。但係短期嚟講，我諗嗰個利率嘅走勢咧，同埋政府嘅房策咧，都會係幾主導個市場嘅。對我哋嚟講就不嬲都揸住貨如輪轉嘅啦，即係。最緊要都係，如果買樓嚟講，都係量力而為啦。但係今日早啲，好似阿 Justin 啱先放咗個佢叫咩啊，深水炸彈。咁所以應該對個市場都幾有刺激性作用啦。
OK，
唔好意思啊，個個睇住我打乞嗤。
OK， 下一條問題咧就係關於投地噶啦。咁咧呢位記者朋友咧就話呢一兩年咧長實投地咧好似表現得比較積極，咁亦都中標咗好多個項目。咁對於近呢幾排咧，亦都有頻頻流標嘅出現。咁你點睇咧？咁同埋會唔會影響咗長實未來投地嘅策略咧？
等一陣真係要打一次。不好意思啊，等等我有花，你唔好摆只花喺我面前。等等 ，OK。唔好意思啊，我敏感花嘅。sorry， 再问多个问题，打一次。喂，
再问多次
个问题得唔得？
好啊
，thank you，
系关于投地嘅。咁呢位记者朋友咧就话咧呢一两年咧长实咧就好似几积极咁样样去投地，咁亦都中咗几个项目。咁但系咧亦都见到咧呢几月咧香港咧就有流标嘅情况出现。咁咧就想问主席你有啲咩睇法，同埋咧呢样嘢咧会唔会影响到长实未来投地嗰个策略咧？
我想我哋中標最主要就係我諗睇翻頭先講咯，啲回報合理嘅，我哋自然就會買地嘅啦。咁呢個就冇乜特別。但如果你係流標，就係買家嘅出價同賣方嘅股價，一個係出價，一個係股價啦。咁唔同咪有咁嘅情出現咯。Over time 股價要跟翻出價噶啦，市場嘅價錢。我哋一路都投地比較係有紀律嘅，即係唔會有個志在必得嘅心態嘅，計啱數咁咪做咯。所以有時合理出價買到咪高興咯，買唔到嘅如果個市場高嘅，好多時候係坐擁失馬嚟嘅。絕對冇話盲目出價，呢個係傳統嚟噶啦。無論係地產啊、基建啊、唔同行業啊，我哋都揸住呢個傳統噶啦。Financial discipline， 即係如果我有幾個字，我哋係差不多口頭禪嚟講，就係頭先我講嘅 choices。第二個就係 financial discipline 咯。
下一條問題咧，就係關於長江集團中心二期嘅。咁呢個記者朋友咧就問咧，我哋嘅重建嘅進度而家係點樣？同埋咧，集團對於寫字樓需求大減有咩睇法？
中環寫字樓始終有啲唔同嘅個 value。我哋都差唔多落成噶啦，應該平咗頂噶啦，就。市場有時會上，有時會落，但呢啲好 long term 嘅。對你記住，對我哋嚟講個成本係好平，好多年前嘅成本嚟嘅。所以我哋淨係重新投資咗嗰個建築費嘅啫。我哋唔係新買嘅土地嚟嘅，不嬲和記大廈以前都係我哋嘅物業嚟嘅。咁而家只係令塊地上面嘅物業更加好咁解啫。就中環始終唔同嘅，慢慢疫情過咗去啦。遊客嚟翻啊，商業活動多啲嗰陣時，我諗對一級嘅海景寫字樓喺中環，係會係最穩陣嗰間咯。即係投資嚟講，你中環核心海景維港冇得再靚噶啦。
Okay, thank you. The following question was about telecoms and was delivered in English.Has the departure of Vodafone's former CEO affected your talk with Vodafone in relation to the merger to Three UK and Vodafone UK? And how confident are you to receive approval from the UK's telecom regulator?
May I ask Kenning to help me answer that question?
Thank you, Chairman. So actually, no, we have, we know the telephone, the Vodafone people quite well. Actually, you know, I have,met, I actually through video with Margarita, the interim CEO of Vodafone, several times already. And then we have very, very good discussions. And in addition to that, my team is in full force discussion with them to finalize whatever necessary so that we can come to a conclusion.I hope that we can come to a conclusion, and then both sides want to come to a conclusion. I hope that will come sooner, quite soon, okay? And, you know, we are the number three and number four player in the UK market. By getting together, we will be achieved a size which is similar to the number two and number three that will enable us to,really to able to compete much better against the big player in the UK market, of course, with the critical mass which we can build a very, very good 5G network across the nations and are able to finance it by themselves. So that will be a very important thing. And of course, we need to get approval from the,regulatory department, the CMA. But there is a different scenario in UK now because in last December, the Ofcom has said that they don't see four player is absolutely necessary for competition. They have to see the result of the merger.To see whether they can produce better competitions. So having a critical mass, better network, and better able to compete, I think that we will be in a good position to get approval from the CMA. So thank you.
Wendy, 睇下有冇或者 Laura 睇下有冇啲關於 telecom 嘅問題咧？如果一次過問阿 Kenning 答埋，可以 read in total context。我想對啲記者都好，
okay,
即係如果已經出咗嚟嘅問題咧，
嗱我睇到仲有兩，應該有兩三條到，
即係啲 property 嘅問題，要開嚟問咧，難明嗰個 total context。
OK，
即係 same with telecom。
OK， in that case I'll have the following two questions about telecom as well， but one is in English and one is in Chinese。Let's do the English one first， OK？Is there room for growth in CK Hutchison's telecom business? Are you considering any further in-market consolidation plans?
Well, it is a very good... Can I? It's a very good question. So then, you know, it actually, you know, the market in telecom, in terms of financial performance, is not easy. As you know, you have inflation costs and you have energy costs coming up. But that what we are doing is that we are having repricing in our base. So and hopeful, and then also our base growth is quite, it's reasonable. It's quite good. So we hope that you know to you know we can offset those cost increase. This is our target in 2023. But if you can recall, we have done some good thing as well in the last 2 years. We have disposed of our tower business, and as a result, we bring in 10 billion euro into our bank, and that reduce our debt, and which is very helpful. With interest rate going up, I think this is a very, very accretive transaction for ourselves. And of course, you know, I have just said you know, the in-market consolidation and asset light is our strategy. We are, in addition, talking to Vodafone on merger. We are in the Nordic market. We are also talking with our prospective partners to see whether there is scope for getting together. So that is Sweden and Denmark. So so that this is the core strategy of Hutchison, and then consolidation bring very accretive well to ourselves. And of course, not the least, we are still on our asset light strategy. And in January, I think this year, we announced that we share the network in Italy in the rural area with our competitor Elliott, so that you know those assets are not utilizing very much by one player. If two players together, we share the capital cost and we share the operating cost. So that will be very good for us. So this is our strategy. Going forward, I think all this strategy will bring growth into ourselves. Thank you.
Okay. My apologies. The whole world listening to me sneeze. But since Kenning has talked about the Cellnex deal, Frank, correct me if I'm wrong. That deal allows us to reduce debt quite substantially. And
absolutely.
Today our debt is almost all-time low, right?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. What is our percentage right now?
We're currently sitting at around 16%.
16%.
Total capital.
Yeah.
Even better than we were at the end of the year.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. 这位记者朋友记得我们在印尼就完成了一项合并。咁佢就問佢話：咁而家呢間合併咗之後嘅公司咧，個業務表現點樣樣咧？好唔好咧？
哦 ，Canning， 你一次過答埋啦。
哦 ，OK。即係呢樣嘢就對我哋嚟講，當然係好好啦，唔係我哋唔做啦。即係好簡單，即係嗰個 EBITDA 嚟講咧，合併之前同合併之後咧，就多咗兩倍，然後咧以前咧，我哋要每年要擠錢入去，就俾佢哋起自己站喎。而家唔使啦。咁啊，反轉頭咧，咁啊，仲要有 dividend 收。舊年佢派咗1.33亿美金，咁啊，我哋都即係全部樣嘢調轉。而且佢哋個因為兩間公司合併埋啦，咁啊有成億幾億四 ，if I remember correct 嘅個 customer 就個公司就。就係好大幾大嘅，咁就個 EBITDA 就 double 咗，唔使拎錢入去，仲可以有剩嘅錢翻，仲可以有 profit， 所以呢樣嘢我哋係好高興。Actually 唔淨止喺 Indonesia 都有呢樣嘢，我哋喺澳洲同人合併咗都係有呢樣嘢，唔使再拎錢入去，仲可以有錢翻，仲有 profit。多謝。
舊年今年嘅我哋講嘅好 deal 就呢幾單㗎啦。
OK。The next question is still for Hutchison and is on ESG. The question is a bit long, the question. Has CK Hutchison adjusted its sustainability goals and strategy in light of issues and challenges such as geopolitics, inflation, and high interest rate that have hit the world last year?
Frank, must be your
your term.
Thank you, Chairman. No, we haven't lowered our focus or our aspirations at all. Sustainability concerns rise above the concerns that you mentioned in terms of geopolitics, inflation, interest rates, and we take them very seriously as a group. In fact, this year was the first year that we've been able to announce a group-wide target of achieving a reduction in our Scope 1 and 2 emissions by 50% by 2035 as against a 2020 baseline. And we've also now for the first time made a public commitment to the pursuit of net zero carbon emissions across our whole value chain, which means Scope 1, Scope 2, and Scope 3 emissions for all of Hutchison's businesses around the world by 2050, which is consistent with the objectives set under the Paris Accords. We don't take this step lightly. We don't set targets unless we are already convinced that we have in hand, right, the plans and the ways to achieve the targets. All of our divisions, our ports, retail, telecoms division, have either set and been validated as to their targets by the Science-Based Target Initiative, or will be doing so during the course of this year, as will almost all of the units in CKI, and indeed the things that are going on in Chung Kong infrastructure are really quite formidable and important, particularly in the area of decarbonization. So we will certainly be continuing this work, not just because it's the right thing to do, but it's also very, very good business. It's something that our customers expect, it's something that our shareholders expect, it's something that our bankers and bondholders expect, and it's something that our regulators expect. And so it's an area in which I believe as a group we lead rather than follow.
主席先生，下一条问题咧就关于长实嘅业绩噶啦。咁咧就嗰个问题咧就系话长实咧就喺公布里边咧就提到咧系有港币148亿嘅已确认嘅物业销售收入咧系未入账嘅。咁究竟喺2023年咧会有啲乜嘢项目咧会系入账咧？
即系Emily，你帮我答答呢个好唔好啊？我哋預計咧就港幣94亿咧，就會嘅銷售收入咧，就將喺2023年入帳嘅。嗰度包括有幾個項目啦，一個明日啦、九套山啦、飛揚啦第一期，同埋一個 Leos 嗰個剩餘嗰幾個項目啦。
咁下一條問題咧？就係關於估值噶啦，咁咧就記者朋友咧就話咧，近期咧先後有啲發展商咧就因為投資物業估值咧就有虧損啊，咁而發出咗刑警啦，咁有啲就出咗個業績之後咧就有虧損，咁對於呢個情況咧，主席先生你有啲咩評論咧？
我唔敢評論人哋啦，講翻自己啦。我哋咁多年嗰個估值就超級保守嘅，我諗保守到有啲行家咩可能嫌我哋太過保守添。所以無論咩市場，我諗我哋除非真係巨型大冧，唔係我哋嗰啲估值就冇乜需要去做再低啲嘅啦。但係唔同公司以前嘅策略唔同啦，我唔可以批評人哋啦。
下一條問題咧就關於英國嘅資產噶啦，咁就話長實同埋長和咧喺2022年嗰度咧就買咗幾個英國嘅資產啊，就有Five Broadgate啦、電信嘅發射塔業務啦，同埋25% 嘅 Northumbrian Water。咁咧就想問咧集團會唔會繼續賣英國嘅項目咧？例如會唔會賣 Green King 咧？
頭先講咗啦，我哋唔係一個香港同外國嘅比較，係喺唔同嘅經濟周期裏邊，唔同嘅資產嘅配置嚟嘅啫。所以從來都冇一個係我哋睇資產嘅，從來好少睇一個國家或者一個地區嘅嘢嚟嘅。咁所以我睇唔到原因，我哋會買Green King 嘅。即係譬如你睇 Green King 喺即係 Covid 過咗之後嚇，即係2022年。Gerald 你聽到的嗬？如果我講錯，你correct me if I'm wrong 嚇。8億3500萬嘅收益貢獻， 比2021年就好了很多了。如果看數是 1600%， 2021年就真的辛苦了。但是、英國酒館不是我們香港人叫的、酒吧來的，酒館不同酒吧來的、酒館差不多是一個地區的人的生活態度和是英式文化來的。所以變成、只要疫情一過少少呢，Green King 的表現是幾抗跌力很強，幾好韌力的。我哋叫 stress test， 佢就幾高分嘅。同埋 Green King 你唔可以諗住淨係酒館，嗰啲係物業嚟嘅。每一個區多數只係，尤其是住宅區咧，多數都係好少批到嗰、那個物業做酒館嘅。所以嗰啲物業又係永久業權，亦都係靚嘅資產。所以我哋有時都會做pub 嘅 trading 嚟嘅，即係有時會賣一啲，有時會賣一啲酒館，即係有啲係變咗地產項目。所以過去呢年都做咗幾多買賣同埋有啲重建嘅嘢嚟嘅。
主席，跟住呢條係有關碼頭嘅，佢話和記港口喺2022年嘅表現如何咧？同埋你對未來嘅港口業務會有樂唔樂觀咧？
2022年咧，港口都唔可以話容易噶，嗰、那個挑戰都幾多嘅。但係和記港口營運算做幾好噶啦。以當地嘅貨幣計算，大約有 10% 嘅增長。但係港口嘅吞吐量雖然跌咗，但係貨櫃嘅碼頭嘅雙停喺個碼頭時間長咗。咁變咗個倉嘅租入又升翻上去，所以果決按年嘅增長率有成30%多。未來幾年咧，我哋喺 Mexico 啦、Egypt 啦、泰國啦、Pakistan 呢啲新興市場咧，都會增加到成5% 嘅產能。亦都會同其他港口有啲相輔相成嘅服務。logistics 啊，物流物業啊，都會喺度增加嗰個貢獻嘅。
下一條問題咧，亦都係問長實嘅業績啦。咁就記者朋友咧就話咧，長實咧喺2022年物業銷售嘅收益咧就大跌咗43%。咁頭先咧亦都講到咧，就話係今年咧就係只係有94億嘅賣樓收入，咁會唔會影響2023年度嘅業績咧？
呢個問題，或者我用一個企得高少少位嚟睇，唔好好似烏低頭咁樣睇嘢。高少少嘅睇法咧，就係、地產係周期性之外咧，係長啲咁樣。每年每年睇，或者甚至乎每季每季睇咧。個意義就唔係好大嚟嘅。嗱，眼前睇嘅咧，我哋仲有9個月賣樓，我哋會增加，希望可以多啲 property 起得切嘅就可以入數。但係呢個唔係我主要嘅答案。頭先個問題，我主要答案應該咁講：早幾年好彩冇喺高啲嘅時候買得太多嘅物業，咁所以變咗未嚟嘅我哋完成嘅物業減少啲。可能是我哋嘅就係、是、我哋嘅強項咯。變咗短期嘅幾多物業起好啊、交數啊嗰、那個唔係我最大嘅擔心，最緊要係我哋平均嗰個 land bank 嘅成本咯。咁我哋平均 land bank 成本，我諗而家係好好競爭力咯。
呢位記者朋友問咧，佢話長和嗰個主席報告書裡面咧就提到。一間公司 Cenovus Energy 就主席就話佢對長和嘅貢獻係上升嘅，咁佢想問咧，呢間公司會唔會成為長和一項重要同埋長遠嘅收入來源咧？
講 Cenovus 即係要睇數啊嚇，唔好意思啊，換好花鏡。Cenovus 應該而家。 CK Hutch 揸住啊 ，Kenny correct me if I'm wrong， 就16.6%。就屋企私人揸住嘅就12.1%，應該係而家有28.7%，即係加埋一齊係最大嘅單一股東嚟噶。而家 Synovus 係每日生產大約80万桶嘅石油，粗數計嚇。Kenny 係咪應該80万桶嘅石油？就為集團提供了非常穩固的盈利貢獻。大概如果只是計 CK Hutch 收到的盈利淨額呢，就應該是港幣60多億的了，比去年就多了10倍。主要都是油價和公司開始那些以前 merger 之後的 effect 出來了。根據 Synovus 宣布的數據來說呢，他們估計2023年的現金流貢獻還多一點。這段時間 Synovus 的股價就升了很多了，現在的股價我們先說，那時候和Husky Merge 的時候是4.8元，現在是20多元的了，那就超過4倍當時的價錢了。所以我們會定期審視我們在 Synovus 的工作，令到為我們的持股為股東帶來最大的利益了。這段時間就 Synovus 很好貢獻。
主席，呢位記者就話：先前你提到屈臣氏嗰個 O plus O 嗰個 strategy 啊，咁佢話呢個 strategy 喺2022咧睇到有咩成效咧
？Dominic 啊，可唔可以有冇辦法係 Dominic 答噶？
啊 ，Dominic 去咗analyst meeting。
哦，
我喺度。
我喺度。
哦 ，OK，good。
喺度 ，Dominic 答得唔得？
好啊，聽我粗略咁答啦。嗱 ，O plus O 咧。都好 unique 嘅，喺屈臣氏度就係線上加埋線下，咁所以呢個策略咧一路睇嚟個成績咧係相當好嘅，咁喺建立咗客户嗰個忠誠度啦，同埋增加到個客個所謂customer lifetime value， 即係一路同我哋賣嘢，咁個價值高咗，咁所以一路咧嚟自我哋發展之後咧一路都進展良好，咁譬如我哋呢個睇 O plus O。個客咧，比起一個普通淨係單一渠道買嘢嘅客咧，係有成3倍以上嗰個多嘅營業額嘅，咁所以個 O plus O 咧係好值得係擴展嘅，咁所以喺舊年啦，2020年咧，我哋喺一方面咧已經係增加咗1300万 O plus O 個客户，咁所以呢個係一個大方向嚟嘅，咁所以我哋一路會繼續做，咁就。有一個好嘅會員基礎啦，佢哋買多啲啦，咁亦都係佢個忠誠度係高咗嘅，咁為公司咧有一個可持續嘅sales 增長。Thank you。
主席先生，下一條問題咧就係關於回購噶啦，咁咧就係記者朋友就問長實同埋長和咧，喺2022年都有作回購，咁而家嚟緊會唔會繼續咧？
咁呢個都幾，我哋講咗一個中長期嘅運作，所以你哋開始睇我哋嘅 result 咧，應該要睇 per share 嘅先準嘅。即係有時傳媒我見到仲係用緊我哋個，即係譬如今年同舊年嘅比較，仲用緊係咗個總銀碼啦。其實總銀碼冇咗個意義啦，因為我哋個股數唔同咗啦。所以希望大家做 reporting 嗰陣時咧，就用翻 per share， 因為我哋 dividend 啊，我哋譬如個 dividend 嘅增長率咧。都是看翻個即係點講啊 ？relate 翻去 earnings per share， 唔係個 total earnings 嘅。今年你睇下 CKA 同 CKHH 個 dividend policy 都係跟翻 earnings per share 個 growth 嚟做嘅。
OK， 講完回購就呢位記者朋友就問增持啦。咁就話2020年同埋2021年咧，李先生咧都有一路都有增持長實嘅股份嘅，但係咧就2022年就冇見到喎。咁今年又會唔會繼續咧？
係咪答咗問題？證監會揾我去傾，咁飲咖啡噶，答得嘅呢啲。
OK， 咁另外咧就講CKA 咧，this is in English. CKA is in a net cash position. What are your capital deployment plans?
Edmund, in terms of net cash position, I think we're over 12 billion at the year end, right? About 12 billion. So we have a good balance sheet. So we have a good war chest on top of this 12 billion to look at new business opportunities. We are in a strong financial position.Good cash on hand, and but we also have a very prudent financial discipline and financial management philosophy. So we can respond very quickly to changes in the market, but we'll also look at new opportunities and new deals. At the end of the day, we're very disciplined. Financial discipline is our middle name.
下一條問題咧，就係問主席先生，你點樣睇香港嘅前景咧？
香港呢幾年辛苦咗嘅，但係我諗我都有信心一樣嘢，就係你有國家嘅支持啦。香港始終係一個國際金融中心，喺貿易啊、航運啊都有佢嘅優勢，同埋我哋嘅人永遠幫到我諗同香港國家同埋外國可以作為一個橋梁角色，呢個係香港人應該最叻嘅一樣嘢，就係同中國同埋外國中間作為橋梁。咁有時橋嘅生意好啲，有時橋嘅生意冇咁好，但係呢個橋嘅作用我諗唔會失咗去嘅。香港嗰、那個。繁榮穩定，我係有信心的。
OK， 主席，跟住呢條問題關於上個禮拜有一單新聞嘅，咁佢話呢位記者朋友話城規會咧，啱啱喺上個禮拜咧就公布長和旗下咧有個聯合船澳咧，就向佢哋咧就遞交咗一個起屋嘅申請。咁佢問點解集團會有一個咁嘅構思咧？
香港一直話唔夠地，唔夠樓。咁我哋通過呢個計劃，俾香港市民同埋香港政府多一個選擇，都成萬五六個單位，我諗係一個好嘅選擇咯。就因為有啲時候出邊唔明嘅，嗰一萬個單位度咧，就係、是、HUD 自己塊地度，但係政府地嗰度嗰四千幾五千個計劃中嘅。公共房屋單位嗰塊地係冇路道嘅，所以發展咗 HUD 塊地咧，起好條路，條路先到到嗰個政府地。嗰塊政府地以前係起青馬大橋嘅 work site 嚟嘅，所以變咗係一路都冇路道嘅，喺個懸崖。而家你去到，如果你喺青衣島度想望到塊地，有時幾辛苦嘅，一個懸崖嘅下邊嚟嘅。所以要落咗去下邊個船廠，由船廠喺海邊先去到呢塊地嘅。所以呢個有道獨特嘅原因，點解我哋話要兩個一齊睇，就係咁解咯。
下一條問題咧就係關於股息噶啦。咁咧就記者朋友咧就話，長實咧喺2021年咧同埋2022年咧都個股息咧都有增長。咁對於2023年會唔會繼續有呢個好消息俾股東咧？
唔好講到咁遠住啦！今年我哋加到息，我諗喺地產行裏邊加到股息，亦都交到功課嘅都唔容易啦。今年我諗我唔係好多間公司全部做到呢樣嘢啦。就我諗我哋嗰個派息同埋唔好講加息，有應該講加派息。加派息咧嗰個睇住個盈利表現咯，盈利好我咪加啲派息咯。咁我成日都講地產係有周期嘅，我哋應該作為地產 operator 係跟住個周期嚟 嚟做嘢，有啲時候可以避到個負面嘅，我哋盡量避。
下一條問題就問我哋關於我哋個酒店業務啦，咁就話對於酒店同埋套房嘅業務咧，主席你有啲乜嘢嘢嘅評論咧？
過去幾年，我諗酒店係全香港其中一個最辛苦嘅行業。好彩我哋有好多酒店房咧，係做緊套房 long term stay 嘅 service suite 嚟嘅，咁變咗嗰啲咧就係本地人嘅生意比較多啲。不過都守咗咁耐啦，終於我哋應該見到啲遊客到啦啩。咁生意應該會慢慢好翻，咁我哋可以做多啲我叫日租嘅生意咯。但係過去我哋月租嘅生意都令我哋嗰個有個好穩定嘅現金流。
跟住呢條問題就係講翻port 嘅。咁呢位記者朋友問佢話：葵涌嗰個貨櫃碼頭咧，舊年個吞吐量咧個跌幅咧係相當之大嘅。咁你覺得香港自己嘅碼頭業務個吞吐量會唔會因為全面復常咧而會得到呢個改善咧？
難講，因為你通脹高，利息上，多數國家的增長動力和需求都比較弱，還有前幾個月的庫存都幾多，即是商家的庫存比較多。2023年頭兩個月的吞吐量和2022年第四季呢，看不到很明顯 的改善，差不多到就我估2023年下半年會好啲啦，頭半年難睇啲，未睇到好好嘅改善。
下一條問題咧，就係有關於長江基建嘅 sustainability 啦。咁呢位記者
好多問題，因為我啱啱收到個 message， 佢追我去嗰個 analyst meeting 啦。
Two more， 好唔好兩條啊？得唔得啊，主席？
係咯。Two more question，
或者我可唔可以一樣嘢啊 ？HL 幫我答嗱，如果有 CKI 嘅問題，留俾 HL 啊，我去 analyst 度。有 Watson 市就到阿 Dominic 同埋 Canning 啦。如果有地產項目，我答埋地產先啦。
好，有一個
跟住我去 analyst。
好，依個有一條地產問題，咁然後之後咧就last two question 啦。OK， 係啦嚇。OK， 嗱地產問題咧就呢位記者朋友就睇到今朝早咧我哋飛揚二嗰個售價，咁佢咧就話呢個單位折實尺價只係港幣11,000多，咁係叫深水炸彈價。咁你點睇咧？有個咁樣嘅價錢？
深水炸彈個花名唔係我改㗎，係即係咁好想像力嘅，一定係 Justin 嘅。但係嗰、那個我哋不嬲都貼市嘅，即係唔係香港人嘈咗咁耐話想樓係 affordable， 想多啲人上到車。咁呢個正正就係、是可負擔嘅上車盤啦。如果我記得冇錯咧，嗰度大部分單位好似六成嘅單位，今次推出嚟都400,000樓下。11,000開始，即係不過我哋公司嚟講就最中意貨如輪轉。頭先講但貨如輪轉唔夠啊 ，Justin 嗰句深水炸彈好聽咯。即係我就講貨如輪轉嘅。咁我哋如果有機會買到平啲嘅地，點解樓又唔賣平啲咧？咁客又開心，我哋又開心，咪貨如輪轉咯。即係。同埋，因為我哋有幾行咧，所以睇嘢會容易啲，企喺個我頭先講話高位角度睇啲咁多咯，褪後少少睇，唔好話高，褪後少少睇成個市場咯。OK， 可以俾我
好啊。OK， 我哋最後兩條問題啦，
係啦，唔關。
OK， 係啦，我最後一兩條問題咧，一條係常見嘅，另外一條就係 Watson's 嘅。
So shall we deal with the Watson's one? Because I'm not sure whether Dominic can stay on for too long. Yeah. Dominic, are you still there? Yeah. Oh, Canning, this is good. Okay. The question is about Turkey's earthquake that took place last month. Okay. The question is, to what extent has AS Watson's retail business been affected by the earthquake? And how many employees does A.S. Watson have in Turkey? And what is the situation? So I think Kenning.
Well, we have about 3,000 employees in Turkey, and it's about 360 stores. And then out of that, 20 stores has been, has been affected. But generally, it was quite normal our operation, and we have helped the situation by donating products worth about 8.5 million Hong Kong locally. So Turkey remain a very important market to us. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Kenning.
金生，下一條問題咧就係關於長江基建嘅。咁咧，記者朋友咧就話咧，能源同埋環境咧係息息相關嘅。而長建嘅核心業務咧就包括好多嘅能源項目啦。咁對於推動環保、可持續發展呢一方面咧，長建其實係有啲咩成績㗎？
嗱，可持續發展咧，可以話喺當今世上已經係一個好重大嘅課題啦。嚇，對於喺長建點樣推動呢個可持續發展咧？我哋嘅主席李先生咧，係一向都俾我哋有兩個層面去處理佢嘅。第一個咧，就好似所有嘅負責任嘅企業啊，對於呢個可持續發展咧，一定要盡力而為嘅。大家都會做好多工作，就係點樣減少排放點樣去節省能源用啊咁。咁呢啲咧喺都好多時做嗰陣時講咧，係有好大嘅社會利益。需要做嗰時咧，需要忍耐，或者甚至乎需要啲犧牲嘅嚇。咁呢啲因為嗰個影響係咁大啦嚇，一定要做，但係咧就對於嗰個經濟效益咧可能有影響，但係咧都要做。咁呢啲咧對長建嚟講咧係不停咁做噶啦。咁葉生咧喺每年嗰個 sustainability report 咧都有詳細講緊點樣做噶啦。咁呢個就係一般嘅因為一個大課題，所以要做必須要做嘅嘢。但對於長建嚟講咧，就第二個層面啦，就係可持續發展咧，其實就係一個長江基建嘅一個核心業務之一嘅。即係長江基建一向都有交通能源啦，交通基線啦，能源基建啦嚇。而家就加多一個咧，就係環保基建嚇。咁喺環保基建裏邊咧，長建已經喺紐西蘭裏邊有一間環保公司，喺荷蘭裏邊咧有一間環保公司。兩間咧，嗰啲業務都係做得非常之好嘅。咁啊，除咗對國家、對社會有貢獻之外咧，亦都對股東咧係提供一個好好嘅利潤。咁啊，事實上咧，2022年比2021年咧係業務根本有增長、有盈利嘅。咁而喺我哋其他嗰啲能源公司裏邊啊，而家好多時都喺度爭拗緊咧，就話究竟用電嚟用能源主流啊，因為煤氣啊，因為天然氣。咁我哋常見嗰啲同事咧就話多樣嘢添嘅，就用氫氣。咁所以咧，喺澳洲嘅能源公司，我哋英國能源公司都積極咁研究一下，可唔可以用氫 hydrogen 嚟做咗呢個主要能源啊？咁呢個就當然啦做到嗰陣時候講咧，嗰、那個經濟效益咧係好大嘅，咁啊亦都得到重視。但我聽講咧，我哋英國做緊嗰樣嘢咧，係俾英國選為咧 the project of the year， 因為嗰個係有好深遠嘅影響嘅。咁所以咧喺呢度喺方面裏邊咧。可持續發展呢個推向啦已經係長建一個其中一個核心業務嚟添嘅。咁所以我諗好多嘢咧，葉生喺佢嗰個 sustainability report 咧都報告咗噶啦。
其實每年咧，大約四月咧，我哋都會 publish 一個 sustainability report 嘅。咁啊，好詳細解釋我哋即係集團對呢個項目點樣，對呢件事呢、這個 topic 點樣做嘅。希望你哋到時多多去參考啦嚇。
多謝金生葉生。好啦，我哋咧剛剛咧就答完咗咧今日最後嘅一條問題啦。喺呢度多謝大家嘅參與。
This marks the end of our webcast press conference. Thank you all for joining us today.
好多謝。